niggas screw their face up at me. On some real shit, son, they don't want beef. I cock that, aim that shit out the window and spray the inner shell up in my heat. Y'all niggas better lay.
What's good, y'all? It's the one and only NY Phenom. If you guys enjoy NFL NBA content, give this video a like. And if you're new, go and subscribe to the channel while you haven't. Now let's get to it. Listen, can we please show Davante Adams some more love? I mean, for real, can we please show Davante Adams the amount of respect that he deserves? The amount of respect that is due. Okay, this guy Davante Adams is arguably the best receiver in the NFL. He's arguably the best receiver in the NFL. He's in the same category as Julio Jones, DeAndre Hopkins, Michael Thomas. He's in that same category. At the minimum, he's the fourth best receiver in the NFL. You can make a case that he's the best, but at the minimum, he's the fourth best receiver. He's in that same tier as the Julio Jones, Mike Thomas, and D-Hops. Listen. The top 100 ranked Davante Adams is the 57th best player in the NFL. That's disrespectful. That's one of the most disrespectful shit I've ever seen. I mean, for real. Now, I'm not going to... truth be told, I'm tired of bugging out about the top 100. I mean, I just don't got time. I mean, this top 100 is a full disaster. This is a full mess. The top 100 is a full mess. So I'm not even bugging out about that because I expect the worst. When I see a top 100, I expect the worst. But at the end of the day, this is what I see. You put Amari Cooper and Stephon Diggs over Davante Adams. Now I'm not showing Stephon Diggs. He's probably a top 10 receiver. He's probably a top 10 receiver. Amari Cooper, when at home, he's a top 10 receiver. But on the road, he doesn't show up. So I need to know why they're better than Davante Adams. Why do people underrate Davante Adams like he's not one of the best receivers in the NFL? And you know you're going to have more receivers. You know you're going to have the Chris Godwins, the Mike Evans, Tyreek Hills in front of Davante Adams. They're going to probably have... they already had Odell. But, you know, overall, like, some of those receivers, they're really good. Tyreek Hill is overrated. Tyreek Hill not a top 10 receiver, but that's a discussion for another day. Chris Godwin's from the ball out. Chris Godwin's going to be one of the best fantasy football players this year if we have a season. But, you know, overall, just skill by skill, these receivers aren't better than Davante Adams. People don't show Davante Adams enough love because he doesn't have that 4.3 speed. He is a 6'5, 225 with 4.3 speed. He's not built like a Julio Jones. He's not Tyreek Hill with 4.2 speed. He's not fun enough. He is not fun enough to the casual eye. But for the real hardcore fans who watch the little shit, the fundamental shit, us hardcore fans, we appreciate Davante Adams. This guy's the best route runner I've seen since Chad Johnson. I mean, for real. Do you see how Davante Adams runs his routes? Do you see how Davante Adams runs his corner routes, runs his deep post routes, runs his end routes? I mean, it's a thing of beauty. It's a thing of beauty, man. And I just don't think Davante Adams gets enough love, man. Like, this guy Davante Adams, week in, week out, is the only real target for Aaron Rodgers, and he still puts up production. I know people will say, well, he didn't have 1,000 yards last year. He's not elite. Well, guess what? He didn't play all 16 games. He played 12. He got injured. The year before, though, he had 13 touchdowns, 1,300 yards. What's really good? And this is him being the number one target with no other receiver options. Okay, for you people... Who's watching this right now? Can you guys name the number two receiver for the Packers? Who's the number two receiver? I just want y'all to guess. While going on Google, I'm going to give y'all some time to think about the number two receiver for the Packers. Yeah, it's hard to think. It's hard to think of it, right? Not that many people know Alan Lazard. Last year, Allison. MVS was a bust. He was a fantasy football bust. It was Davante Adams or bust last year. And Davante Adams still found a way to get it done. Did you guys not see what Davante Adams did to my Seahawks in the divisional round? He tore our secondary up with just pure route running. And I know people will say, well, he has Aaron Rodgers throwing the football. He is the best thrower in NFL history throwing the football. Well, listen, you guys can't have it both ways. You guys can't have it both ways. Because all I've been hearing is Aaron Rodgers is on a decline. Aaron Rodgers is washed, and he's not good enough to get it done. So my thing is, you can't have it both ways. You can't have it both ways. Either Aaron Rodgers is still the elite quarterback he was in 2014 and 2016 and 2011, or Devontae Adams is just as good. And truth be told, listen, Aaron Rodgers is still elite, but Devontae Adams is that top tier receiver. He's as good as any receiver in the NFL. Sure hands, catches everything, best route runner in the NFL. Football wins. He's just smart. He got the intangibles. You guys gotta start showing love to Devontae Adams, and it's disgusting. That's disgusting. We talking about all these quote unquote underrated receivers. Well, Devontae Adams is a true underrated receiver. He is. He is, man. And like, you would think that he would get more credit because he plays in Lambeau and he plays for the Green Bay Packers, but surprisingly, he doesn't. Okay, like, come on, man. Like, this guy's he's arguably the best receiver Aaron Rodgers has ever had, and Aaron Rodgers played with some great ones: Jordy Nelson, Greg Jennings, Donald Driver, James Jones. This guy, Aaron Rodgers, played with great receivers. But I'm not sure they're as good as Devontae Adams. I mean, come on now. Who was this number two target, man? MVS wasn't shit. Alan Lazard, you know, they didn't start looking at Alan Lazard way until later in the year. Alan Lazard was arguably the number two receiver. And I bet you half the people that's watching this vid, outside Packers fans, don't even know who Alan Lazard is. I mean, Jimmy Graham didn't show up until the division round versus my Seahawks in the fourth quarter when they needed a crucial third down. I mean, Jimmy Graham was nowhere to be found. I mean, Jimmy Graham was put in the milk box. I mean, for real, where was Jimmy Graham last year outside versus my Seahawks last year? So, you know, overall, Devontae Adams, listen, he had no other receivers to take the pressure off him. I don't think people realize how hard it is to ball out when you have no other receiving threats on your team. This is why you got to respect the Devontae Adams. This is why you got to respect even the Mike Thomases, because they didn't have elite receiving play around them. At least for DeAndre Hopkins, you can say, well, he had Will Fuller. He had Kenny Stills. At least for Julio, you can say he had Calvin Ridley. When you talk about Mike Evans, he had Chris Godwin. For Chris Godwin, you can say he had Mike Evans. For Stephon Diggs last year, he had Adam Thielen. This guy, Amari Cooper, had a 1,000-yard receiver lined up across from him. So at the end of the day, my thing is, bro, Devontae Adams, he's the most underrated receiver in the NFL. And he's just as elite as any receiver in the NFL. If you want to call Devontae Adams the best receiver in the NFL, I wouldn't debate you. I wouldn't. This guy Devontae Adams is amazing. He just deserves more respect. I'm not just talking about the top 100 either, because multiple people don't show Devontae Adams the amount of respect he deserves. All right, but that's all I really got to say, man. I expect Devontae Adams to ball out if we have an NFL season this year. But his players are dropping like flies. I mean, every 5 minutes it feels like someone's opting out. But that's all. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. I'm from number one, and I'm out. Deuces.
Shout out my Crips, they're still crippin', nigga. Shout out my Bloods, they're still bloodin', nigga. Straight from the dirt, shout out my muddy niggas. Came from the bottom, all my get money niggas.
When I die, you ain't got to cry, you just got to pray. Put some weed where I lay, I'ma see you another day. Full of energy, you my enemy, you got to pay. Was on the east side, fucking with them Crips the other day. Was on the